Hello everyone, welcome to IELTS Speaking Mod Test conducted by FocusOnIELTS.com. I'm Nurani, an IELTS tutor from BC, and today I'm going to analyze Radian's answer, the IELTS tutor that I have interviewed in the previous video. I'm going to analyze his answers based on the four criteria. Well, let's get started. Well, the first criteria is his fluency and coherence. Well, his answers were well organized and clearly delivered. His paraphrasing was great. He didn't repeat the question. Instead, he used another word, phrases, or another sentences. And then he only did occasional self-correction, and he was able to use linking words appropriately to connect his idea, such as and, however, and in order to. And the last one is he was able to maintain the flow of his speech that it is clearly presented. Let's move on to the next criteria. Okay, about his lexical resources, he could use a wide range of vocabulary, so I managed to listen to hear several adjectives like surprise, marvelous, and noble in describing his answers. And then when he was asked about questions related to food, he was able to use vocabularies related to food, such as healthy, unhealthy, taste, and smell. And also, okay, he could use the vocabularies correctly. And then one of the drawbacks that I managed to hear is there is a word that he kept repeating. That was the word business. So when he was asked questions about business, okay, I think that's in speaking part two, he kept using the word business. I think that he could use words like firms or companies, yeah, to replace the word. And the third criteria is his grammatical range and accuracy. Well, most of his sentences were error-free. He could use a wide range of structure, and he could use them accurately. There are several tenses that I managed to hear, like past tense, both in active and passive. Okay, such as I cried a lot and my mom decided to just stay at the class. I was surprised. My mom would leave me and it was the follow-up. And then I also heard present perfect. I have seen this on TV a lot, and technology has been the backbone of business or companies nowadays. And then he also used comparison, like more active and more fun. However, there were few grammatical errors that I managed to hear, like if a lot of people gap, it will increase. So this is a type one, conditional sentence type one, so it should be give, not gap. And then when he was asked about his childhood, okay, he said, so I will not cry. Yeah, it should be would. And then there was also an error in plural and singular. So he said, I didn't have a lot of responsibility. Well, it should be responsibilities. Okay. But overall, his grammar was excellent. And then he could also use complex sentences in which he combined two clauses using connectors such as because. And the last one is his pronunciations. Well, his pronunciation is clear and easy to follow. I can listen to every word that he said. And then he was also able to stress and use intonation effectively to convey the meaning. Okay, that's all from me. Let's meet in the next video. See you again. Bye-bye.